Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day so far. Today is a very special day. It's Diwali. And the first thing I did was to check how the weather is today. It's been raining this morning. I hope the rain stops by evening. And another special thing about this vlog is this is my first day in my life vlog, my first big video, and I'm very excited. I hope I get it right and I hope you like this video. So this year Diwali is on a Thursday, which means a working day for all of us in the US, and kids have school, so they're eating their breakfast right now and I'm making some pasta. This is spaghetti with marinara sauce and some cheese for their lunch. So their lunch and snacks and their school bag is all ready to go, and they are wearing their socks right now and they're all set to go for school. After breakfast and tea, I ran the iRobot to vacuum the house and I started getting ready for the festival. I was planning to do some special cooking today. So first off, I was planning to make carrot halwa. It's been a while since I made this, but I'm going to follow the recipe that my mom taught me. And so here I'm cutting the carrots. I'm not going to be grating them because it's too much for me, so I'm going to be using the food processor for this. After grating the carrots, cook the carrots in a pressure cooker. I cook them by adding some milk to it instead of water. So you can add just add the right amount of milk that such that the carrots are all covered. And here I'm using an Instapot. You can also use a regular pressure cooker. If you're using a regular pressure cooker, just set it wait for like 2 whistles before you turn it off. For the Instapot, I set it up for 12 minutes on pressure cooker mode. The night before Diwali, me and my daughter wanted to I wanted to put some mehndi, and I wanted to put some on my daughter as well, but my son insisted that he wanted it too, and so I drew a simple card on his request and I also wrote his name. It was a fun experience for the kids. I usually do this for Diwali. I just want them to remember the little things associated with the festivals. So here's a more elaborate design for my daughter, and she also did some of it. It was really fun. They enjoyed it a lot, and she managed to keep it for at least like 40 minutes. And after that, they were making some designs on paper. They had a good time. So coming back to our Diwali preparations, I'm also planning to make paneer dum biryani. So for that, I cut some onion, I made some ginger garlic paste, and I'm also taking some capsicum. And I chopped these into big pieces like that, and I took some cilantro here, and take some paneer and cut it into little bigger blocks like you see here. Next, I'll be marinating the vegetables for the biryani. So I took some yogurt, ginger garlic paste, turmeric salt, and coriander powder. I did not add any mirch, that's garam masala, and I added some 2 spoons of lemon juice to it. I did not have biryani masala. You can also add biryani masala if you have it, and I did not add any spices because I wanted to make something not too spicy so that the kids can also enjoy it. Now stir up these ingredients well. Now add the vegetables to this mixture and stir it well, and then you can put it in the fridge so that it marinates well. I leave it in the fridge for at least 1 to 2 hours. I forgot to add amchur powder, so I added that now. This is optional. If you don't have the powder, then you can skip that. While the carrot halwa is cooking, I was doing some other chores around the kitchen, like unloading the dishwasher and loading the dishwasher. I was planning to finish everything before the kids came back from school, and we were planning to pick them up a bit early today so that they could take a bath and be ready a little early. Now the cooker is done, so open it and check the consistency. And since it's still a little liquidy, I put it in the saute mode, and I'll be cooking it till the liquid evaporates. And I'm also adding some cardamom powder to it. Cook this on a low flame and add sugar as needed. I think I added around 1.5 cups of sugar to this. Once you get this right consistency, garnish it with raisins and nuts of your choice. So here I took almonds and raisins. I had a quick lunch of rice and dal that I made in the morning, and I'm back to some more decoration now. So I'm done with the carrot halwa. I still have the biryani to make. I'll probably make that in the evening, closer to when we eat, so that it's nice and warm. So yeah, right now I took some like artificial leaves, and I'm making that pattern with them. So here's the pattern up close. I took 4 leaves and I just stitched them up with a needle. It was very simple and easy to do. You can try it. I took 3, and then I added another one to it. Next, I put the yellow flower in the center using tape, and we are all done. So that's the simple decoration I did. Finally, it has stopped raining and the weather is looking good now. I hope it stays that way. For making the biryani, soak around 2 cups of rice in water for 20 minutes. I took 2 cups, you can take according to how much you need. So, and then next up, boil some water, around 8 cups of water here. And I added some oil, salt, and some cardamom and cloves to it, and bring this water to a boil. We'll be using this for cooking the rice. And remember, we should not completely cook the rice. We should just cook it, like partially cooked rice is good enough. Once the water comes to a boil, add the rice that you had soaked earlier, and cook it until it's almost about 70% done. Now remove the water and keep the rice aside. In a separate pan, take some oil, ghee, bay leaf, cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, and some jeera, and slightly saute them. After this, I added some onions to it and sauteed them until they're golden brown. Next, added some tomatoes, as you can see here. Next, add the vegetables that we had marinated. So here's the paneer and capsicum that we had marinated earlier. Cook the paneer for a few minutes and then layer it with the rice that we had prepared earlier. Cook this on a low flame for about 5 to 7 minutes, and you can garnish it with onions, cilantro, mint leaves, and some ghee, and also saffron if you have it. And then wrap it up with foil and put a lid on it. Make sure the flame is on low. While I was getting ready, the kids got hold of my camera and they did their own recording. Yes, no!
Punch, hold it, hold it.
Hold on to him. Wait for him. Wait.
Time out.
Is it fetish?
Is it lunch?
Show me.
Close the door.
Close the door. Had a great time playing with the sparkles, and I also enjoyed it. So this is the best part of Diwali. My husband made some yummy potato pakodi that we ate for dinner along with the other items. Here's our simple Diwali dinner: carrot halwa, paneer biryani, some salad, and potato pakodi by my husband. This was our simple Diwali celebration at home this year. Please do let me know in the comment section how you guys celebrated Diwali. And I'll see you guys with another video next week. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.
Happy Diwali!